Hello everybody, today I have the review of the Apple TV by Apple, of course. So I'm just going to go ahead and get straight on into this because this is going to take a little while. As for the design of this, it's an all black little box, 3.9 inches square, and it's got a black bezel all around the sides of it. And as you can notice from the pictures that I'll put on here, it does get fingerprints quite easily on the bezel and on the top. And on the top it has the Apple TV logo. As for the hardware, inside it's running an Apple A4 chip, as in the iPod Touch and iPhone. You can use Wi-Fi up to the N frequency, so full Wi-Fi, and it's all built in right into the Apple TV. You can run up to 720p HD video, which I have to say I'm kind of annoyed of, because come on, any TV can run 1080p now. Any HD TV can run 1080p. Why not Apple TV? It only weighs 0.6 pounds, so it's extremely light. As you can see, I can throw this thing around and, you know, do everything with it. It's not that heavy at all. As I said before, it's only 3.9 inches square, so 3.9 inches deep and wide. And it's just below an inch deep, so it's 0.9 inches to be exact. So it's very, very skinny, and I'll have a picture around here somewhere to show you how skinny it is. Now as for the ports on the back you have the power, you have the HDMI port, you have the mini USB port, you have the optical audio port, and then you have an Ethernet port if you want to plug in to a hardwire to make it a little faster. And as for the remote, it is the same remote as the universal dock that I did a review of earlier this week. And as for the software on this TV, I'm not exactly sure if it's running an iOS sort of software on it. I could guess that it does, but they probably made their own software for it. And the mini USB port is actually used to upgrade the software on it. You can rent movies for $4.99 in HD, and I think it's $3.99 for SD, or standard definition, as us geeks like to call it. To buy these things, you can link it to your iTunes account wirelessly, or if you want hardwire it, you can. So if you have an iTunes store account, you can just go ahead and sync it up and it'll tell you how to do that and stuff. You can stream off an iPod Touch 4G, an iPhone 4, and the iPad, so with the AirPlay feature on all those, now you can use that with the Apple TV on here. Stream off a Mac or PC. So with my Windows laptop right there and the Macs, we can all stream right to the Apple TV, and you can select speakers that you want to play off of. So you can play your music, you can play your TV shows, you can play your movies, you can even play movies that you make in iMovie right on the Apple TV. And if it's already in 1080p HD, it'll convert it down to 720p and play it on the TV that you want to play it on. Thank you.
Somebody's got my baby.
Also stream Netflix, so if you have a Netflix account, you can get movies straight off of Netflix on here. And I'm not exactly sure how the streaming is on that, how fast it is, but I imagine that it's just as good as the Apple streaming abilities. And as for my actual review on the product, I think this is a great little box that Apple has made. I think they have a very long way to go. They say that it's just a hobby for them. But I think, just as the iPhone was, I think they're going to make it a huge thing, kind of like the Google TV. I think they'll actually make a TV out of this Apple TV and put streaming directly into it. So, the only thing I have problems with is the remote. It's a little tiny and kind of basic. I feel like I need a bigger remote. And I feel that the streaming could be a little faster. I don't know if it's my router because I am on Wi-Fi. But the streaming seemed a little slow at first. Okay guys, that was the review of the Apple TV by Apple, of course. I'm going to go ahead and ask you to please click that little subscribe button at the top. It'll give you my videos every time I make a new one, so it'll pop up on your homepage. And go ahead and comment down below, and please, please leave a thumbs up down below. It really helps my ratings on YouTube, and I spend a lot of time on these, so I feel like I need some more ratings from you guys. And go ahead and leave a comment on what kind of videos you want me to do, because one of my videos, the iPod Touch and how to use the voice control on it, I got a ton of views off of that, so I don't know what else you guys want, just little tips off the iPod Touch or big reviews like this or things like that. So just go ahead and leave a comment on what you want me to do and what you want me to review on. I can try and review specific things. If they're really expensive, I can't do that. I try and do stuff on the iPod Touch or the iPhone since they run basically the same software. So that is it for this review. I'm Rob's Technology. Peace.